Is President Trump sending a message tonight, a bat signal to political allies and former aides in the sights of the Mueller investigation? Are his pardons a way of telling them, don't worry, I have the power to pardon you too? Just like I pardoned Dinesh D'Souza, Sheriff Joe Arpaio, and Scooter Libby. Doesn't matter if you've pleaded guilty, like conservative flamethrower D'Souza, who was sentenced to 5 years probation and a $30,000 fine for violating federal campaign finance laws. So are the president's pardons all about politics? We'll have more on that in just a moment. And that all comes on the day the president doubled or tripled down on his demands for an apology from ABC in the wake of Roseanne Barr's firing for that racist Twitter attack on Valerie Jarrett. The president making it all about him again, tweeting, Iger, where is my call of apology? You and ABC have offended millions of people, and they demand a response. How is Brian Ross doing? He tanked the market with an ABC lie, yet no apology. Double standard. The president completely ducking the point there. Roseanne's tweet was straight up racist, yet the president failed to condemn it. Why? Because he can't. Because his own words and actions are racist too. So let's review. Back in 1973, the Trump's family real estate company was sued by the Justice Department for racial discrimination. They settled without admitting wrongdoing, but were required to take steps to prevent discrimination. And that was just the beginning. 1991, in a book, it's called Trumped, by former Trump Casino executive John O'Donnell. Donald Trump said, quote, black guys counting my money? I hate it. The only kind of people I want counting my money are short guys that wear yarmulkes every day. Those are the kind of people I want counting my money. No one else. Racism and anti-Semitism all rolled up into one quote. In 1989, Trump took out this infamous full-page ad in four New York City newspapers demanding the death penalty for what he called, quote, roving bands of wild criminals. This is in the wake of the rape of a white female jogger in Central Park. Five black and Latino teenagers were wrongfully convicted of the crime and later exonerated. Yet Trump was still insisting on their guilt in 2016. And listen to what Donald Trump told NBC. This was in 1989.
A well-educated black has a tremendous advantage over a well-educated white in terms of the job market. And I think sometimes a black may think that they don't really have the advantage or this or that, but in actuality, today, currently, it's a great, I've said on occasion, even about myself, if I were starting off today, I would love to be a well-educated black because I really believe they do have an actual advantage today.
Well-educated black. Fast forward to 2011, when Donald Trump embraced the racist birther lie that Barack Obama was not born in this country.
I want him to show his birth certificate. I want him to show his birth certificate. There's something on that birth certificate that he doesn't like.
Oh, my God.
I brought it up just routinely, and all of a sudden, a lot of facts are emerging, and I'm starting to wonder myself whether or not he was born in this country.
So I would like to have him show his birth certificate. And can I be honest with you? I hope he can. Because if he can't, and if he wasn't born in this country, which is a real possibility, if he doesn't, it's one of the greatest scams in the history of politics.
And remember, he asked for the college records, too, on top of that. Finally, in September of 2016, Trump said this.
President Barack Obama was born in the United States, period.
Yet he reportedly still clings to that birther lie today. And there is so much more, much, much more.
They're bringing drugs. They're bringing crime. They're rapists. Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States.
I don't know David Duke. I don't believe I've ever met him. I'm pretty sure I didn't meet him. And I just don't know anything about him.
You also had people that were very fine people on both sides. You had people in that group. Excuse me. I saw the same pictures as you did.
And on and on and on. Those are the receipts. Why doesn't President Trump condemn racism? His own words and actions tell you why. He's a racist.